Please stand or remain standing and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God. Dr. McLeod, members of school committee, parents, family, and friends, guests, and of course, the reason why we're here, grade 8 students. It is a pleasure to welcome you tonight to the third annual Hopkinton Middle School promotion ceremony. The goal of tonight's promotion ceremony is to appropriately and properly show the tremendous accomplishments our students and your children have made in 3 years and the pride that each of us has in this special place called Hopkinton Middle School. Before we begin tonight, I would like to thank and acknowledge the efforts and time of Mrs. Carrie Connor, Mrs. Mary Ellen Grady, Mrs. Mary Puella, Mrs. Ruth Pegluca, Mrs. Jeannie Bernardin, Mrs. Tammy Nudeau, Mrs. Janine Hagen, and Mrs. Ann Benbenek in making tonight happen. I also want to take a brief step into the past to acknowledge the start of this event 3 years ago. The pioneers who took this idea and helped create this evening, Mrs. Mary Ellen Grady and two parent volunteers, Mrs. Kathleen Carpy and Mrs. Liz Pomeroy. I would also like to thank Mr. David Purdy, Mr. Jeremy Dodge, Mr. Craig Hay, Mrs. Lisa Conant, Mrs. Catherine O'Toole, Mrs. Caitlin McDonald, and our amazing grade 7 band for their accompaniment tonight. And finally, so you don't have to clap twice, or two different rounds of clapping, I want to thank Mrs. Rita Balboa, Mrs. Lori McBride, Mrs. Kelly Burke, and Weston Nurseries for their beautiful floral display, our custodians, and the many parent volunteers for beautifying this space and helping tonight with logistics. Dear 8th graders, what a journey you have been on, which ends tomorrow at precisely 10:45, but who's counting? I'd like to start this evening by reading a book to you. But don't worry, I know it's hot. It's a picture book, if I can find it. I'd like to start this way because, after all, it was the way that I got to meet many of you when I came to Hopkins 5 years ago as part of the Hopkins Community Reading Day. The book is called What Do You Do With an Idea by Kobe Yamada. And of course, because I'm so far from you, you won't have the benefit of pictures. One day, I had an idea. Where did it come from? Why is it here, I wondered. What do you do with an idea? At first, I didn't think much of it. It seemed kind of strange and fragile. I didn't know what to do with it, so I just walked away from it. I acted like it didn't belong to me. But it followed me. I worried what others would think. What would people say about my idea? I kept it to myself. I hid it away and I didn't talk about it. I tried to act like everything was the same as it was before my idea showed up. But there was something magical about my idea. I had to admit I felt better and happier when it was around. It wanted food. It wanted to play. Actually, it wanted a lot of attention. It grew bigger and we became friends. I showed it to other people, even though I was afraid of what they would say. I was afraid that if people saw it, they would laugh at it. I was afraid they would think it was silly. And many of them did. They said it was no good. They said it was too weird. They said it was a waste of time and that it would never become anything. And at first, I believed them. I actually thought about giving up on my idea. I almost listened to them. But then I realized, what do they really know? This is my idea, I thought. No one knows it like I do, and it's okay if it's different and weird and maybe a little crazy. I decided to protect it, to care for it. I fed it good food, I worked with it, I played with it, but most of all, I gave it my attention. My idea grew and grew, and so did my love for it. I built it a new house, one with an open roof where it could look up at the stars, a place where it could be safe to dream. I liked being with my idea. It made me feel more alive, like I could do anything. It encouraged me to think big and then to think bigger. It shared its secrets with me. It showed me how to walk on my hands because, it said, it is good to have the ability to see things differently. I couldn't imagine my life without it. Then one day, something amazing happened. My idea changed right before my very eyes. It spread its wings, it took flight, and it burst into the sky. I don't know how to describe it, but it went from being here to being everywhere. It wasn't just a part of me anymore. It was now a part of everything. And then I realized what you do with an idea. You change the world. I'm hopeful that the book and my message here tonight will soon connect. It doesn't seem that long ago that when you were grade five students sitting here about three years ago, with your grade five teachers, and we were welcoming you to Hopkinton Middle School. How many remember that? All right, good. That's not too bad. I was thinking we might need to do some work with making it a more engaging presentation. At that time, we talked to you about the great things that Hopkinton Middle School had to offer you. We talked about clubs, our wonderful related arts classes, amazing academic curriculum, nature's classroom, dances, field days, athletics, and lip dubs. These were all concepts. These were all things. These were all ideas that occurred at Hopkinton Middle School before you came. But these things exist for you and were only successful because of you, because it was only when you came here that these things came to life. We mentioned clubs to you at that presentation, but it was Daniel Nolan who made it happen through the golf club. We talked about improving our school through an advisory, but it was Liam, Corinne, Celia, Aaron, Landon, Francesco, Izzy, Luke, Maggie, Niall, Sarah, and Emma who made that actually happen. We talked about a member of our school representing our Hopkinton Middle School with Governor Patrick, and it was Lydia who made that happen. We talked about the power of Chris Heron and his idea that he presented, but it was Christian who raised funds to send to the Heron Foundation. We never talked about this, but when a bus, let's call it Bus 5, ran into some problems. It was Nia, Anna, Natalia, Julia, Sage, Bella, Alexa, Kate, Alexandra, Priya, Amanda, Olivia, Sarah, Kaylee, Maria, Taylor, Abby, Sarah, Jane, Anna, Amanda, Sophie, Elise, Abby, Emma, Francesca, Neil, Patrick, Jack, Jordan, Ethan, Garrett, Liam, Dan, Robbie, Chase, Corey, Austin, Matt, Ryan, Jack, Dan, Gabe, Ben Grant, Hayden, John, Aaron, John, Colin, Kyle, Mr. Gundez, Mr. Cheney, Ms. Wilson, Mr. Lancer, and Ms. Proudman, who turned what had could be the potential for a very, very low light into a highlight, and they made a lifelong memory out of it. My point, grade eight students, is simply this. Hopkinton Middle School is a building. It's a structure. All the things we told you about when you were in grade five are just things, and you made them come to life. The teachers and the staff here supported you in making these things come to life. Each one of us brings ideas, concept, and plans to life. The people here, each one of you, our outstanding and committed staff and your parents have helped to create the experience that we call Hopkinton Middle School. As you move forward in your life, I look for you to continue to be the amazing people that you are, that you continue to learn from your teachers, from life experiences, from each other, and finally, from yourself. Remember that the places you go, the structure that you occupy, are just ideas. It is you that has the power to transform, to improve, and create your present and your future, to transform the world and your world. And at this time, I would like to invite the teachers from the Mercier team to the stage for the presentation of their academic awards.
This year's Mercier Team English Language Arts Award honors a student who has consistently given 100% effort all year long. A student who reads thoroughly to find a deeper meaning. And a student who writes with a voice that reveals passion and insight. She truly exemplifies learning for the sake of learning. I am proud to name Caitlin Sylvester as the recipient of this year's ELA award.
Thanks to the work of so many of you in this room today, I have numerous students in my history class that impress me all year with their knowledge and their curiosity. However, this student rises to the top because he has such a love of history that he comes into my classroom every day with an incredibly positive attitude and a genuine excitement for the topic. We talk history movies, he draws me pictures of topics we studied in class. This young man's passion is not just for a good grade, but for the subject itself. And it is for that reason that I proudly present the Mercier Team History Award to Mr. Garrett Powers.
From smashing impact craters to constructing roller coasters, the Mercier Team Science Award recipient has shown dedication and curiosity in all areas of science. A team player and a positive influence in class, this scientist has demonstrated both a passion for science and a strong desire to pursue either technology or engineering in the future. I'm proud to award the Mercier Team 2015 Grade Science Award to Drew Nealon.
Stephen King once said, "What separates a talented individual from a successful one is hard work." This student is a perfect combination of hard work and talent while still maintaining her humble and kind nature. The Mercier Team Math Award goes to Amanda Hansen. Thomas Edison said, "There is no substitute for hard work." Our team's recipient of the Determination and Character Award is one of the most hardworking students the Mercier team has ever had the pleasure of teaching. She has a fantastic attitude and is always smiling and optimistic. She is incredibly kind to her peers and her teachers. A poised and polite young woman, she is sure to experience great success in her future. The Mercier team is proud to present the Determination and Character Award to Miss Julia Cirillo.
And now the O'Connell team will present their awards.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. Is it hot enough for you? As most teachers know, it is a real challenge to look at the novels we teach year after year with fresh eyes and with the enthusiasm we had the first time we read it or taught it. Even a beloved classic like To Kill a Mockingbird can run the risk of becoming stale after year 10. What keeps the novels fresh and fun for me is when I can look at it through the eyes of my students. I had the opportunity to engage with a student on a very long 20-mile walk where she told me this was her all-time favorite book. When I asked her what it was she liked about it, she said she just loved the characters. When I asked which character she loved, she said, I love Atticus, and I love Jem, and I love Scout. I just love them all. Hearing her say this and seeing her come into class each day with a reaction of joy or surprise or anger, depending on what she had read the night before, reminded me of how I felt first reading this book and why I loved to teach it. For her enthusiasm for not only this novel, but for all things English class, this year's O'Connell Team English Award goes to Molly Freshman.
Good evening. Thank you. Each year I like to give the History Award to a student that does not shy away from solid discourse and debate in the classroom, while at the same time maintaining an open and questioning mind. This year there were several students that fit that description. One student, however, stood out slightly above the rest. This year's O'Connell Team History Award goes to Tim Lane.
Math Award on the O'Connell team goes to a person who's given 100% all year long. This person consistently persevered even through the most challenging of problems. This member of the accelerated algebra class had 100% homework average, but what's even more impressive is that they maintained a 97% test and quiz average over the course of the year. Not only was this person exemplary in their studies, but was also willing to help anyone. This year's Math Award goes to Eva Curavilla.
I had the pleasure of having many exemplary science students this year. The winner of the O'Connell Team Science Award consistently showed and performed at a high level in science. The interest, the attention to detail, just the curious questions that they always had, often discussing topics with me outside of class. So it gives me great pleasure to award this year's O'Connell Team Science Award to Zach Holbrow.
The O'Connell Team Determination and Character Award is presented to a student who exemplifies resolve within the classroom and courage in the face of adversity. In Harper Lee's To Kill a Mockingbird, small-town lawyer Atticus Finch explains to his young son that a person's true character is revealed when you know you're licked before you begin, but you begin anyway and see it through no matter what. Here, Atticus is alluding to an upcoming trial in 1930s Jim Crow South which may seem like apples and oranges when thinking about life at Hopkinton Middle School. However, we as teachers see determination and character each and every day in our classrooms. We see it in students who take every challenge head on, who show perseverance when times get tough, and in those who see things through no matter what. It is my pleasure to present this year's O'Connell Team Determination and Character Award to Mr. Christopher North.
At this time, we will have the Dowd team teachers present their team awards.
John Steinbeck wrote in his last novel, The Winter of Our Discontent, "I wonder how many people I've looked at all my life and never seen." Today, I want to present the English Language Arts Award for the Dowd team. I've selected a particular student who I wish tonight to be seen, recognized by all of us for his great dedication, character, and mind. This student has been chosen because of his remarkable hard work at bettering his abilities to read, write, and think. His academic accomplishments have been truly outstanding. Please join me in celebrating this very special student, Sanshiro Uyama.
Science Award is given to the student who has consistently gone above and beyond in all aspects of their coursework. The student has maintained academic excellence throughout the year, demonstrated a passion and expertise for the subject, both in class and beyond the classroom, and has best exemplified the minds and habits of a budding scientist. The recipient of the Dowd Team Science Award for 2015 is Sarah Kang.
The Mathematics Award goes to the top student in my accelerated algebra class that has shown both high achievement and a passion for math that extends beyond the classroom. Whether he's graphing ellipses, discussing the infinite volume of Torricelli's trumpet, or quoting his brother's calculus book, he routinely comes to class sharing his latest math discovery with enthusiasm and humor. The winner of this award is Aaron Erikalian. Mr. Dowd could not be here tonight, so I'm presenting his history award. So the history award for the Dowd team goes to a student who is inquisitive about the past and who looks to make connections in the world today. This love of learning and willingness to explore various points of view is commendable and serves as a lesson to all of us. I am pleased to present the history award to Abby Fisher.
I'll be presenting the Dowd Team Determination and Character Award. The Dow team is pleased to present this student who has throughout the year shown herself to be responsible, resilient, and having a sound moral compass. She is kind to everyone she meets and has proven to be an excellent ambassador for HMS, both in the school and in the community. Additionally, she is a great help to her mom in caring for the horses that board at her barn and is following her dream next year as a freshman at Norfolk Aggie. Congratulations, Madison White.
And now the Foreign Language Department will present their awards.
This student is self-motivated, conscientious, and dedicated to embracing opportunities to speak French as much as possible. She is curious and eager to learn about and experience cultures in the Francophone world. She is persistent in striving to strengthen her communication skills as she pursues her path toward proficiency in French. She demonstrates a tremendous enthusiasm and positive attitude for learning. She is kind, respectful, always on task, and willing to help others whenever she can. It is my pleasure to present the Grade 8 French Award to Emma Edwards.
This student was chosen because of their love for learning something new. This student had not taken Spanish prior to arriving to Hopkinton Middle School at the start of this school year. However, this student demonstrated independence and success in the Spanish classroom. I am proud to give this Spanish award to Alexandra Lazaroff. Mrs. Caruso is unable to be here tonight, and so I'm going to present her award. The student that Mrs. Caruso chose to receive the Spanish award left Hopkinton for seventh grade, and when he returned in eighth grade, he had received no previous instruction in the language. Despite the deficit, he has risen to the challenge and placed himself with his peers ready for ninth grade Spanish. Mrs. Caruso chose Ben Wheeler to receive the Spanish award.
This student is among my top students in Spanish class this year. Though Spanish comes easily for her, she is very humble. Instead of flaunting her knowledge, on numerous occasions, I have witnessed her patiently explaining concepts to other students. During small group activities, she works well with her peers, challenging them to discover the answers on their own, rather than giving the answers that may have come easily for her. She participates regularly in class, and I always look forward to calling on her as she has a beautiful accent. She always does her best work and often asks questions that indicate connections that she's making to the material outside of the classroom. I know she will be very successful in her study of Spanish, both at the high school and beyond. This year, my Spanish award goes to Leah Portal Davila.
And now the Wellness Department will present their awards.
Thank you. My award for achievement in physical education goes to that student who's a role model for every other student here. I could have called this the Turn My Back Award, as I could always trust this student to be doing the right thing even when my back was turned, whether it was in games, dance, or racket sports. This outstanding student always gave great effort and could even be seen after school shooting baskets in the gym using a water bottle for a ball. And on top of everything else, she has great taste in Broadway musicals. Maya Vumbaka.
The individual receiving this physical education award has had a great impact on every student's life in this room. You might not understand the amount of that impact now, but I hope you all will be able to reflect on it in the future. We are all lucky because we have had the privilege of sharing the last 3 years with him. When you all set your goals this year, his was to walk on the treadmill 26.2 minutes per day. He did that and more. In class, his skills have improved greatly because of hard work and a lot because of all your kindness. This year's Physical Education Award goes to Max McNamara.
It is my honor to give this award to a student that I have had for the last 3 years. She is a true team player, always gives her best effort, and is a role model student for others. It is clear that she values fitness and health. Most of all, she has a great attitude and is a pleasure to know. I will miss you next year, and good luck, Annie Feather.
Being new this year, I had many 8th grade students that I thought would deserve this award, but I could only choose one. I decided on one in particular because she was always one who was like, she was my calm in the storm. She kept me calm when her class might have been a little chaotic at times, and I knew I could look to her to ask thoughtful questions. I knew she was listening, and she always added to class discussion. So I'm very proud to give this year's Health Education Award to Jane Stillwell.
And now the Drama and Music Awards will be presented.
Good evening. Drama, as you know, is a mirror that holds up the truth of all humanity to us, which can be very, very scary. But it can also be incredibly magical. Drama, as its nature, functions as a community. We all say that we function like the biggest dysfunctional family in the world. And yet it's out of such madness that such magic happens. It takes a lot of inspired, talented, and brilliant people like all of you, to make such wonderful things happen. And we have had a wonderful year together in class and out of it. of all of you, the drama community wishes to recognize Anna Jeffress.
I have had the absolute honor of teaching the two Chorus Award recipients for 3 wonderful years. These students have come to class each day, working their hardest with a smile on their face, singing with true passion, and leading by example every single day. They are truly role models for the dedication it takes to be a musician and will make perfect additions to the high school chorus next year. I truly look forward to hearing what they do in the future and with their craft. Congratulations, both Alexa Benak and Ben Leibowitz.
I have 2 General Music Awards to give out tonight. The first General Music Award goes to a young man who consistently shows pride and creativity in class. He is someone that strives for the deeper meaning in music and values the power that music can have on people. He is constantly on a quest for knowledge and uses music as one of the many ways he expresses his mature voice. The second award goes to a young lady who is a constant positive presence, bringing light to each person's day. She is supportive, kind, and has led by taking chances and always being herself. All students and teachers were moved by her powerful depiction of Demi Lovato's Warrior through her own creative movie. The awards go to Lizzie Karp and Hayden August.
I'd like to present the band awards. So choosing a student for the band award is like asking a parent to choose their favorite child. This year's ensemble was exceptional in many different ways, so I chose to go with 2 students who performed with quiet confidence and made a significant impact on the entire ensemble, likely more than they realized. This year's recipients are Matt Bianculli and Bella Onsi.
One of the best parts about my job is that I get to meet these students as 5th graders in Hopkins, and I get to work with them for 4 full years until they go into high school. The Orchestra Awards recipient has shown exemplary skills in performance and leadership during her years in middle school. The Orchestra Award this year goes to Molly Rancourt.
And now we will have the remainder of the Related Arts Department present their awards.
Hi, Mrs. Ho could not be here this evening, so I am presenting the Digital Literacy Award. The award this year goes to a student who worked very hard in her class. He was always nice and helpful to others who did not know how to do something as quickly as he did. He created a great final project and joined the technology club to show his skills to the school. It is her pleasure to give the award this year to Tim Pelzinski.
Mrs. Brummett and Ms. Lee could not be here this evening, so I will be presenting the award for Dynamic Media. This award goes to a student who has a positive, can-do attitude and is always focused and dedicated to her work. Not only does she excel in her own work, but she was helpful to other classmates and worked well with others during group projects. She pushes her own sense of design and composition and takes pride in her work, which is evident in all the projects she has produced this year. I'm happy to present her with the Dynamic Media Award, Serena Panagiotopoulos.
This year's art award goes to a student who I have been happy to see walk into the art room for the past 3 years. Her artwork ranges from serious to sarcastic, from realistic to abstract, but it's always personal, well-crafted, and just generally awesome. She provides endless encouragement and compliments to her peers, is open to feedback, and takes pride in every step of her work. I'll miss her presence in my classroom next year, especially during art club, when we've had time to make artwork together and chat. I am thrilled to present this year's art award to Sierra Schlussel.
Start thought. The best form of leadership is leading by example. The 2015 Progressive Leadership Award goes to that eighth grader who doesn't just act the part of a leader, but makes leadership a part of every action. If a collaborative team could be made up of just clones of this one person, it would be the most positive, efficient, effective, empathetic, creative, kind, aware, and maximized team you have ever seen. This person leads by example and lives a way that we can all work to emulate. This year's 2015 Progressive Leadership Award goes to Sam Cody.
And now I'd like to invite Ms. Norby to present the Library and HCAM Awards.
Good evening. The following student took full advantage of the library's resources over the last 3 years. In addition to being a voracious reader, this student often dropped in to relax and read a magazine after school or just to touch base with the library staff during the day. I am proud and honored to give this year's award to an outstanding Hopkinton Middle School library user, Elise Miller. And
and I'm presenting the HCAM Award for Mr. Cousins. The student selected to receive this year's award has been very active since the beginning of the club and has also grown to be a regular volunteer at HCAM. The award proudly goes to Matt Bird.
Now I'll invite Mr. Meehan, who will award the Student Spotlight and Best Buddies Awards.
All right. The Spotlight Award is an embodiment of not only school citizenship and academic perseverance, but of resilience, character, spirit, and the drive to make a world a better place. The choice for the award this year, I'm going to name it now, but I want to talk about him a little bit, is going to go to Matt Davis. Matt, where are you? Just put your, there he is right there. I want to talk about Matt first before you come up. Matt was born with a congenital heart defect that was to require surgery last year, and it's a terrifying prospect, as you can imagine. And I have to say, I found that when I was meeting with Matt, it was Matt who was actually counseling me. His attitude was incredible, the way he refocused himself on the positives in life, what he was thankful and grateful for, and that he was just going to get through this no problem was just inspiring. About a month later, the surgery was not a complete success, and he had to face a second major surgery. And again, inspirational. I remember him saying he did it once, he could do it again. You know, resilience is an astounding quality, and I always, where some cave, others rise above, and that's who Matt Davis is. He touches everyone around him in a positive manner. He's caring, he's kind to everyone. He faces each task with a positive attitude, and it's contagious to those around him. He's a conscientious student. He's achieved honor status in every marking period. He's a valued citizen, a role model, and an inspiration to those around him, and I'm proud to award Matt with the Spotlight Award. I'm now going to present the Best Buddies Award for Jim Casey, who I have to give a shout out to because he does such an incredible job with such a special program. So this next award goes out to an eighth grade student who has been a dedicated and important member of the HMS Best Buddies program for the past 3 years. This individual has demonstrated the commitment and positivity that has made Best Buddies such an important experience for so many of our students. He always comes to meetings with a smile and has made a lasting impression on our program. He will be missed next year. And that's why this year's Best Buddy Award goes to Ben Leibowitz.
And now we invite Marie Smith to present the Women's Club Award.
Good evening. My name is Marie Smith. I am president of the Hopkinton Women's Club. The Hopkinton Women's Club mission is to promote social and educational culture amongst its members and to provide service to the community. One of our goals is to reach to the town folks of Hopkinton, old and young. The Hopkinton Women's Club President Endeavor Award is a newly created award given to an eighth grader who demonstrates perseverance, determination, and earnest and industrious effort, especially when sustained over a period of time. The award comes with a $100 Amazon gift card. We've asked the assistance of Mrs. Grady and the school counselors in choosing this year's recipient. It is with pleasure to present this year's President's Award to a young lady who has shown these qualities, Francesca Bianchi. Francesca, please come on.
At this time, we would like to acknowledge four students who were recognized earlier this year with awards that honored students from across the state of Massachusetts. Would these students please stand when I call your name, and I ask that you hold your applause until I've introduced all four. Lydia Rudden as our Project 351 Ambassador, Luke Lydon, who received the John F. Kennedy Make a Difference Award, and Justin Normando and Caroline Centrella as the Commonwealth of Massachusetts Middle Level Educators Scholar Leaders. Congratulations to these four outstanding students. Now I'd like to invite Mrs. Mary Ellen Grady, who will award several awards at this time.
I always come kind of messy. This Shane DeRoche Memorial Award is a very special honor. The award goes to three distinct students who, like Shane, are respected by many and create a positive energy wherever they go. These students have unique, quirky senses of humor and a different perspective in class. They are kind, approachable, and a friend to all. The second annual Shane DeRoche Memorial recipients are, and if you could hold the applause till the end, from the Mercier team, Claudia Stelt. From the Stuckles team, almost listened, Sam Cody. And from the Dowd team, Matt Dempsey. Please come up. Dave Laquadaro was a volunteer in our school who came to the work in the office after hours. He was a true gentleman who was welcoming to our entire community. He was a generous individual who always looked for ways to quietly help anyone in need, especially our students. The recipients of the Dave Laquadaro Award who embody these very qualities are, again, three, so hold it. From the Dowd team, Young Wang. From the Mercier team, I'm sorry, I probably have this mixed up, Will Puella. And from the O'Connell team, hopefully, Mac Lynn.
Yeah.
All right, the next award is the School Spirit Award. The School Spirit Award goes to a unique individual who continuously shows school spirit and pride in our school. Each Spirit Day, she creates a better outfit or costume that shows her Hiller pride. Without a doubt, the most deserving member of the class for school spirit is the one and only Marguerite Gaughan.
Tonight, we recognize two students for the School Community Award. Their presence in our school helps create a sense of community among peers, classmates, teachers, and staff. These students embody the idea of community, camaraderie, trust, respect, and commitment. Our School Community Awards go to Caroline Paul and Celia Potus.
Finally, the Principal's Award goes to the student who has made a significant, lasting, positive impact on our school through leadership, determination, and the ability to work with others. This student has consistently exemplified leadership skills and maintained outstanding grades throughout middle school. He's received high honors each trimester at Hopkinton Middle School. This student works well with students and adults alike at HMS. This student always speaks respectfully without fearing what others may think. He is consistently kind to others. He demonstrates integrity and is always engaged in the classroom. He has been a member of student council for 3 years, is a member of Ignite, and has the distinct honor of being the only member of our student body that gets to hang out with Dr. McLeod, members of school committee, Mrs. Ben Bennick, and several other adults on the calendar advisory committee. Finally, and possibly most importantly, he is a passionate learner. Even if his grade on an assessment is outstanding, he still wants to understand the mistakes he made. He exemplifies a growth mindset, always looking to improve. He looks at information in a different way and continually tries to make connections to prior learned knowledge. His teachers report that he has forced them to look at problems in a new way. This year's Principal Award goes to Alex Swojcik.
At this time, we will have our presentation of certificates to the 8th grade students, and we welcome Mrs. Abates homeroom.
Could you hold your applause until all of the students have received their certificates? Everybody wants to get to that dance tonight. We ready? Caitlin Abbott. Joseph Barnes. Noah Buontello. Madison Burney. Marissa Caffone, Taylor Fortunato, Dylan Gillespie, Cora Hartigan, Caitlin Jurassic, Ryan Kelleher, Niall Kelly, Emma Mann, Mitchell Marcoux, Taylor McLaughlin, Elise Miller, Ivy Massagia, Christopher North, Michael Roach, Daniel Sage, Camelia Schemmel, Susanna Schroeder, Brianna Toko, next we're moving to Mr. Hayes's class, okay. Matthew Bird, Matthew Brown, Matthew Cardillo, Kayla Champagne, Samuel Cody, Brett Crochere, Lucas DeLoya, Brett Daly, Matthew Davis, Ashley Donley, Alina Fajardo, Annie Feather, Molly Freshman, Luke Glidden, Tess Greenwood, Nicholas Hines, McCallum Lind, Corinne Messier, Sydney Moran, Ryan Muldoon, Stephen Simos, Caroline Waters, Emily Welsh, Jenna Wilworth, Maya Zent. Riley Babin, Michael Balerna, Ryan Brown, Natalie Calkins, Grace Kavanaugh, Mitchell Chandler, Madeline Dolly, Grace Dustin, Luke Fairbanks, Allison Fujiyoshi, Abigail Furlong, William Hubner, Benjamin Leibowitz, Sydney McDonald, Madison Marcoux, Dylan McBride, Molly Rancourt, Daniel Salber, Ty Scanlon, Evan Sizitsky, Danielle Sullivan, Landon York. Peyton Burns, Morgan Dradsbeck, Brian Herlihy, Zachary Holbrow, Caitlin Hawley, Abigail J. Ryan Kester, Eva Cravilla, Timothy Lane, Bridget Lee, Matthew Long, Michael McCabe, Cecily McNamara, Lydia Rudden, Jacob Schmidt, Nalin Storm, Alexander Wojcik, congratulations to the O'Connor team. Next, we have Brianna Antonoli. Oh, not according to me. Gabriel? Oh, got it. Sorry. Sorry about that. Hayden August. Charles Baker. Emma Beal. Matthew Bianculli. Isabel Catino. Francesca Duca. Marguerite Gone. Amanda Hansen. Ryan Hawkins. Daniel Joyce. Andrew Keeley. Abby Kelly Lancer. Raymond Lucas. Benjamin McKenzie. Justin Normado. Robert Paluca. Did I get it? Caroline Paul. Claudia Stett. Jane Stillwell. Catherine Wolfine. Brianna Antonoli. Nope. It must be. Okay, here we go. Okay, sorry. Should never put me in charge of this. Gabriel Amaro. Haley Bernardo. Allison Berdulis. Theodore Cavalho. Meredith Coffey. Sophie Goodnow. Jordan Hannah. Maddie Holden. Fahad Kawaja. Alexandra Lee. Philip McCarthy. Emma McNamara. Andrew Nealon. Sydney Olafson. William Puella. Alexandria Power. Garrett Powers. Hannah Southern. Emily Whalen. Good, Sarah. Now, Brianna Antonoli. Jack Brennan. Julia Cirillo. Jason Domsky. Cole Glassburn. Juliet Jacobs. Brendan Kelly. Christian McDonald. Jack McDougall. Maxwell McNamara. Emma Meek. Lauren Nordling. Timothy Palzinski. Serena Papagiannopoulos. Not even close. Papagiannopoulos. Yeah. Izzy Puri. John Riley. Megan Sward. Thomas Villa. Maya Vumbaka. Young Wang. Nicole Woodward. Okay. Is it Carrie? Yep. Joshua Altman. Elizabeth Barnes. Leah Brossi. Marguerite Card. Tyler Doherty. Alexandra Holmes. Pamela Karp. Olivia Kershey. Gage McCormick, Grant McNamara, Brianna Mitchell, Eli Peterson, Benjamin Powers, William Scannell, Robert Scanavan, Jack Sloan, Caitlin Sylvester, Brianna Thomas, Patrick Webb, Gabby Wielding, Christian Williams, John Youssef, thank you. Is that Noble team? Okay. That was the Mercier team. Give them a hand. Okay. Next, we have Aaron Arakalian, Sarah Cahill, John Cowan, Matthew Dempsey, Cam Fatahi. Okay. Anna Feng, Abigail Fisher, Julia Fowler, Neha Gopi, Colleen Graham, Priya Hedgedy, Sarah Kang, Rohan Kapoor, Ethan Kramer, Amanda Mack, Isabella Onsi, Andrew Paleko, Neil Patel, Michael Puvakard, Sanshiro Uyama. Sorry. Benjamin Wheeler. Okay, it should be Corey Banyan. Nicholas Bradley, Caroline Centrella, Isabella Cerulli, Olivia Quivello, Emma Edwards, Natalia Gomez, Chase Griffin, Catherine Hagen, Anna Jeffress, Ryan Joyce, Alexandra Lazaroff, Daniel Logan, Blake Manning, Nikolai Markovich, Sage Ratcliffe, Adam Rowe, Jacob Simmer, Kyle Stuckel, Colin Thine, Aaron Tran, Caitlin Wilson, Kian Bari, Francesca Bianchi, Sarah Dunn, Davin Evans, Alexandra Guerra, Kaylee Cohane, Liam McGinnis, Ryan Minan, Sophia Marks, Haley Marshall, Taylor Pardoon, Andrew Pearson, Leah Portal, Daniel Proudman, Kinsley Rolfe, Corey
Rozowski, Peyton Salyards, Maria Santiago, Sierra Schuschel, Flushel, Eric Schwartz, Dan Sinicole, Madison White, Rakoya, Alexa Benak, David Bradley, Isabella Callery, Mitchell DiPaolo, Megan Halloran, Shreeman Komajirati, Mackenzie Lockhart, Austin Marks, Allison Marr, Lucas Moynihan, Connor Murchie, Julia Nadeau, Celia Potus, John Symes, Kevin Sullivan, Leah Toronto, Hayden Van Beek, Jack Walker. Please give a hand to all of our graduates. Could everyone please give a warm welcome? We have Kinsey Rolfe, who is the winner of the eighth grade speech.
Bonjour, hola, hello. Most of you know at least two of these languages, some even three. Learning a new language is part of our journey through middle school, and today is the day we celebrate reaching this journey's destination. During our middle school career, we matured and transitioned into teenagers. Our academic intelligence grew as the years went by. In math, we learned algebra and geometry. In science, we increased our knowledge of the human body by learning cells. In social studies, we learned about ancient civilizations, such as the Mayans, the world's geography, and history. Finally, in English, our comprehension of various novels, short stories, plays advanced. Before we move on to the high school, I want to first revisit our years here at HMS. Sixth grade was our year of firsts. First day of middle school, first trimester, first relay, kids' night out, field day, and even more. Some of us joined drama, taking part in our first plays. If you sang or played an instrument, we performed our music concerts on a real stage. Our parents entrusted us with our first cell phones, and we started Instagram accounts. This started it all. Hashtag social media craze began. On the weekends, we would force our parents to bring us to the Hunger Games movie. By the end of the year, we celebrated our academic intelligence through the capstone of Elder T. With this, we celebrated the lives of those influential adults who most impacted us. That year came and went, and then we were seventh graders. Seventh grade is still an important year, but it gets lost in the middle. We do not have a big project such as Elder T, and it's not our last year at HMS. But we celebrated the smaller things, like our school dances, where we perhaps danced with that special someone, or found the courage to ask our crush to the dance, or even found ourselves in our first relationship. There may even have been a few first kisses. We were the middle grade and hung in there, like on our field trip to the ropes course. The whole trip to the YMCA was spent with all of us raving about the release of the new hit novel, The Fault in Our Stars. Then the movie came out, and the same actor starred as Triss in Divergent, and we stood starstruck. In seventh grade, we also expanded our horizons with the opportunity of learning a new foreign language. The majority of us chose to take Spanish, and a small portion French. We celebrated new vocabulary words and recited new verbs religiously, all of us wanting to accomplish being fluent. Finally, the sun rose higher and summer came in like a tornado. We spent our summer at the end of seventh grade tanning underneath the blazing sun and reading Trouble. Eventually, the novel came to a close, and so did our summer. And as fall leaves breezed by, and eighth graders we became. During eighth grade, we acted like every day was a celebration. This was our first year playing a school sport. Soccer, field hockey, baseball, softball, basketball, volleyball, hockey, and track were the first teams we were immersed into. Some games we won, some games we lost, but still remember the victorious moments, but more so, the friends we made. Our class is extremely talented in sports. Big shout out to the sports teams who went undefeated. Yeah! The celebration continued on into our trip to DC. And every waking second, we enjoyed the bus rides, monuments, and spending time with friends. You would think by today, celebrating seems overdue. And yet, the celebration goes on. That is what this night is all about, celebrating our three magnificent years at HMS. Throughout these years, we gave back to the community with Relay for Life, Timlin Race, Boston Strong, ALS Ice Bucket Challenge, and more. Thank you, teachers, administration, and parents for helping us get to where we are today. Felicitaciones, amigos. Congratulations, friends. We reached our destination.
As we close tonight's celebration and your years at the middle school, I'd first like to address your parents. Congratulations, you have survived these 3 years as middle school parents. I myself have finally, yes, you get applause. I myself have finally completed my 8 years as a middle school parent and can attest to the fact that it is both joyful and trying at the same time. To your teachers, both current and past, thank you for caring so deeply not only about the subject you teach, but about the students who sat before you. To my fellow administrators who have had the pleasure of watching your growth since sixth grade, thank you for ensuring that our students were engaged in meaningful learning experiences throughout their 3 years here. And now to our students. I'd like to take these last minutes to reflect on what you've learned while at Hopkinton Middle School. You've learned a lot. You know far more than you did when you entered our school back in September 2012. You have mastered how to use a comma with an adverb clause. You know about the systems of linear equations. And back in sixth grade, most of you had no idea what Renaissance humanism was, or about energy transformations, or how to ask to use the bathroom in another language. We feel confident you are academically ready to move on to high school, but more important than the academic preparation you've gotten, we hope we have prepared you for life, to be honest, kind, compassionate, and empathetic young adults who think critically and independently. Let's revisit the literature you have read over your middle school years and how these life lessons have been reinforced through the characters you met. In sixth grade, you learned to see the world in a different way through the eyes of Cassie Logan in Roll of Thunder, Hear My Cry. During this coming-of-age story, Cassie learns about the racism that exists around her, yet perseveres and finds a way to bring everyone in the community together, despite everyone's differences. In seventh grade, you met Jonas in The Giver. He is raised in a society based on sameness. Without color or emotions, the community has never experienced the value of diversity, love, of creativity, and intellect. Until Jonas himself begins to receive the memories of war, birthday parties, and family, he never knew or understood what it meant to be unique and respected for those things that allowed him to stand apart from everyone else. He also shows us that though many life experiences will be difficult, by persevering even through the worst days, the joy and love will be more deeply felt and appreciated. This year, as eighth graders, you were introduced to Atticus Finch and his daughter Scout in To Kill a Mockingbird. At one point early in the story, Atticus tells Scout, "If you learn a simple trick, you'll get along a lot better with all kinds of folks. You never really understand a person until you consider things from his point of view, until you climb into his skin and walk around in it." Take what you've learned from these characters. Do as Cassie Logan did and continue to help your community thrive. Let Jonas's act of freeing his community from sameness remind you to persevere even through the most difficult experiences, for it is both love and sadness that will guide your future. And if you are ever in a situation you don't know what to do, if you are ever faced with a moral dilemma, or in trying to understand the perspective of another, just ask yourself, what would Atticus do? As you leave us now and head off to high school, please don't forget any of the things we've taught you, how to use a comma, or how to be strong, empathetic, and kind. Finally, in the words of the chief elder from The Giver, thank you for your childhood. Last but not least, I would like to introduce our student performers, Claudia Stett and Alexa Benak. They will perform Whenever You Remember. We respectfully request that you do not clap along as there are tempo changes throughout this musical piece.
Hello? Okay, hi.
When you look back on times we've had, I hope you smile and know that through the good and through the bad, I was on your side when nobody could hold us down. We claimed the brightest star and we came so far, and no, they won't forget, yeah. Whenever you remember times gone by, remember how we held our heads so high when all this world was there for us and we believed that we could touch the sky. Whenever you remember, I'll be there. Remember how we reached that dream together. Whenever you When you think back on all we've done, I hope you're proud. When you look back and see how far we've come, it was our time to shine and nobody could hold us down. They thought they'd see us fall, but we stood so tall, and no, we won't forget, yeah. Whenever you remember times gone by, remember how we held our heads so high when all this world was there for us and we believed that we could touch the sky. Whenever you remember, I'll be there.
remember how we reached that dream together. Whenever you remember, we claimed the brightest star and we came so far. You know that we showed them all, and no, they won't forget. Whenever you remember times gone by, remember how we held our heads so high when all this world was there for us and we believed that we could touch the sky. Whenever you remember, I'll be there. Remember how we reached that dream together. Whenever you
We'd like to thank you all for coming and celebrating our students tonight.